एवरीवन, आई एम नुपुर बांकर विद माय फेलो टीममेट्स दत्तात्रेय भोपळे, भूषण बिरजे, यश गजबिये एंड आनंद रत्नाकर विल बी डिलीवरिंग अ प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन एटीएम विद एन आई. नाउ यू माइट बी वंडरिंग व्हाट एन एटीएम विद एन आई मीन्स, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द प्रेजेंटेशन. नाउ देर इज एन अर्जेंट नीड फॉर इम्प्रूविंग सिक्योरिटी इन बैंकिंग रीजन. सो विद एन एडवेंट ऑन ऑफ एटीएम बैंकिंग बिकेम ईजियर एज वेल एज इट became vulnerable. So the chances of misuse of such much hyped insecure product ATM are manifold due to the exponential growth of criminals day by day. This situation is unfortunate as there have been tremendous progress which have been made in the biometric identification techniques, including the laser technology, fingerprinting and retina scanning, etc. So this report proposes the development of a system that integrates facial recognition technology into the identity verification process used in the ATMs. The development of such a system would serve to protect consumers and financial institutions alike from frauds and other breaches of security. Let's move on to what an ATM is. We all know ATM stands for Automated Teller Machine. It is a computerized telecommunications device which gives access to the account holders as well as bank for making transactions and withdrawals 24/7. Next comes the PIN, which is associated with the ATM card. PIN is nothing but personal identification number. It is a method consisting of a confidential code, numerical passcode, which is used by the bankers to given to us to protect our account from unauthorized access. The fewer people who have access to PIN, the much better it will be. And you always have to remember your PIN in account of opening your account. Paper proposes an automatic teller machine security model that would combine a physical access card, a PIN, as well as an electronic facial recognition. By forcing the ATM to match a live image of customer's face with an image stored in a bank database that is associated with an account number, the damage which can be caused with the help of stolen ATM cards as well as PINs can be neutralized. So, I would like to hand it over to Yash Gajbiye to explain further slides. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Yash Gajbiye and let us start with the purpose of an ATM with an app. So there are two purposes also known or concerns. They are environmental concerns and security concerns. So the chances of misuse of this much hyped insecure baby ATM manifold due to the exponential growth of intelligent criminal day by day. Here we mean that the hackers are increasing day by day, so the security of the ATM is compromised. It can be easily hacked, so we need to increase the security. Also, there is an urgent need for improving the security in the banking region. As I said, with the advent of ATM through banking became a lot easier, it even became a lot vulnerable, so the hackers can hack the ATM, so we need to increase the security. Also provide a cordless free way to get the money out of an ATM. So the techniques which can be used to increase the security are as follows: fingerprinting, retina scanning, facial recognition and iris recognition. So these techniques are specified, they are unique and for each person, and without that person the security cannot be breached. So this technique should be implemented. So working camera based in a cash machine will detect the pattern in a second, compare it with one stored in central computer or encode onto the cash card. So the camera might be very useful if it is installed in an ATM. Also a sensory system examines randomly. The iris is the colored part of the camera which will be checking in unique to every person, as unique as fingerprints.
Hello everyone. My name is Bhushan Birje. Today I am going to explain the uses of iris technology and the working of iris technology. So let's start. In previous slides, Mr. Yash said that nowadays the number of hackers increases. So the problem of insecurity arises. So to avoid this problem, We use the many biometric technology into the system, like fingerprinting, retina scanning, facial recognition, and iris recognition. But the iris recognition is considered to be the most accurate biometric technology available today. So using of the iris technology, we can use secure our information. Using this technology, the use of this technology is to serve to protect the consumers and financial institutions like from fraud, and it is also used in other branches of security. This is the picture of the ATM on which there are many cameras are installed, like external camera, portrait camera, safe camera, cash slot, or dispenser camera. These are the snapshots from portrait camera and cash slot camera. So the iris is an internal organ of the body, but it can visible from outside. It is located between the cornea and the lenses of the eyes, as shown in the figure. So the purpose of the iris is to control the amount of light that enters the eye. The iris has complex random patterns which differs in each eye. No two eyes can have the same iris pattern, not even the two eyes of the single individual. So we can secure our password. What is the working of this technology? Let's see. So the steps of the iris working, it takes the photo, then it localization of the iris, then determination of the outer and inner borders of the iris, filtering of the usable structures for the analysis, determination of the vector of the usable structures, calculation of the iris code. But how we can keep it as a password from the eye? So when the image is captured, is then processed by the special kind of software which will identify the iris from inner and outer boundary of iris. Now the iris pattern from the image then encoded into the 512-bit code called as iris code, and this code prepared for security purpose.
So hey guys, my name is Anand. So now we move towards next point, which is iris identification step. So in that, this gadget first of all points to your face image, then it detects your eye regions, then it focus on your iris. Then if it successfully recognizes you, then it redirecting towards your account, or else it will throw out an error. So talking about iris recognition, the most important thing is iris scanning measures the iris pattern in the color part of the eye. Means it only recognize the colored part of the eye. Next point, working. Match the live image of a customer's face or eye, and this image is associated with your bank account number. Then when the data is matched, then the user considered as fully verified. But the most important thing is a system can examine just the eyes, eyebrows, mouth, ears, and so on. So in other words, the first of all, it wants your face image or eye image, then it recognizes you by iris patterns. Then if it recognizes you, then it redirecting towards you to your bank account.
Here the algorithm behind the working shown by the flowchart or the data flow diagram. So first of all, it wants to enter the PIN.
then if the pin is correct, then it directing towards you in to the iris scan. Then if the pin is not correct, then try again or it will throw out an error. So now if the pin is correct, then it scan the iris is match successfully, then it allows to you withdraw the cash. If no, then try again. So if you observe carefully, you find out this flow diagram consists of various shapes, just like square, then diamond shape, or and the arrows. So what did they mean? So they mean first of all, square means input any statement or any value, just like pin. Then this box, then the diamond box, which is also known as decision making box. So in that way the working happens.
Hello everyone, my name is Dattatre. Further slides will be explained by me. Here are the advantages of any team with an eye. The entire process of biometric identification takes time less than 2 seconds, which includes fingerprinting, retina scanning, facial recognition, and iris recognition. The system works equally well with the customer wearing glasses or contact lenses. For using this system, no special lighting is needed. The camera also does not use any kind of beam. Iris scanning are much more accurate than other high-tech ID systems available, such as voice scanning. The iris is the best part of the eye to use as an identifier because there are no known diseases of iris, and also eye surgery doesn't perform on the iris. An ATM with an eye is far safer, faster, more secure and accurate than DNA testing, because if there are identical twins, they don't have identical iris. The iris remains same from 18 months after birth until 5 minutes after death. Next is the disadvantages of an ATM with an eye. For identification of iris, it has a small target of 1 cm to acquire from a distance of 1 meter. It is located behind a curved wet and reflecting surface. It can be obscured by eyelashes. Also, it can be partially occluded by eyelids. Next is the troubleshooting. Troubleshooting is a form of problem solving, often applied to repair failed products or processes. It is needed to develop and maintain complex system where the symptoms of a problem can have many possible causes. Next is the conclusion. We thus develop an ATM model that is more reliable in providing security by using facial recognition software. By this, we even try to maintain the efficiency of this ATM system to a greater degree. Thank you.
So hey guys, we covered all these points about an ATM with an eye. So now we recap all these things.
Like you, be strong to hold the powers of the sun. To dream.